Do you run your own business? Or maybe you're an entrepreneur, or perhaps you just like to save time while you're online. Well, then this video is for you because I'm sharing with you 7 websites which are going to make you look amazing online and help you save time. So let's dive in. Now, the first website on our list is VizMe. Now, VizMe is a tool to help you create any design project that you want. And yes, we're talking so much more than just social media. Whether it's presentations or documents or maybe even graphics for your own website, VizMe has you covered and allows you to edit anything that they provide here with their templates. But perhaps my favorite VizMe feature of them all are their branded templates, where all you need to do is add your website address and it will pull in your logo and your brand color in just a few minutes. Let me show you how it works. All I need to do is enter in my website's URL. So yeah, I'll use Simpletivity.com in this case. I'm going to select Go, and what VizMe is going to do is extract as much information, including my logo, my brand colors, even the fonts from my website so that I can start to use that within the VizMe editor. After it's done pulling in a bunch of information, I may need to select which of these images is my logo. So that is my logo there. I'm going to select Next. Next, you can see it's identified the fonts from my website, and it's even identified some of the fonts that it does not yet contain. But no problem, if I want to, I can upload them here as well. So in this case, I'm going to add these two to my brand kit here, and I'm going to select Next. Next up, it's pulled in some of my colors. And yes, that blue is definitely a Simpletivity blue. I'm also going to add that green and this black as well. And yes, let's add this sort of off-white that I use quite frequently. I'm going to hit Next, and then I can choose which type of theme am I most interested in. I really like this creative theme, so I'm going to select that as well. Now, the great thing is that it's not going to limit me to just one or two templates. No, it's going to bring back more than 30 different templates that I can use in a variety of ways. Now that the branding wizard is finished, I can go through and take a look at some of the templates that it's created. Here you can see that it's got my logo and my colors and my fonts directly within some of these templates. I like this one here. I've got my logo here at the bottom. I particularly like this infographic here on the right-hand side. It's even about boosting productivity. It's got my brand colors. It's got my logo here at the bottom. And of course, all of this is editable, so I can apply this and start to customize it for my own needs. So if you're looking for a quick and easy way to apply your brand to some amazing designs, be sure to check out VizMe. Now, the next website on our list is called Cloud Convert, a free way to convert almost any type of file to any other type of file format. Whether you're talking about documents or images or audio files or literally almost anything, Cloud Convert can allow you to do so. First off, what I like is that we can select our file from a variety of places. It doesn't have to be from our computer. You can actually go and just grab a URL from the web or connect it to one of your cloud services. But in this case, I'm going to grab an image from my computer. I'm going to grab this logo here. So here in the top right-hand corner, it shows that it is a PNG file, but maybe someone is requesting a WebP file from me, and I don't have any of this software on my computer that will do that for me. I don't want to go searching for that. Why not just come right here to Cloud Convert? So I'm going to select that type here. I can choose this little gear icon if I want to make a few additional adjustments. I'm going to say that everything is okay, and then I can select the convert button. Now, of course, depending on the size of the file and what is being done, it may take a few extra moments, but now I have this image in the correct file format. I can download it and I can use it anywhere that I like. So if you need something that is quick, easy, and allows you to convert up to 25 free files per day, be sure to check out Cloud Convert. Now, the next website on our list may not exactly be new to you, but I've included it here because we often forget how fast and easy it is to create a website with Google Sites. When it comes to website creation, we're often talking about names such as Wix or Squarespace. However, if you want to produce a website for free and do it quickly and easily, there is perhaps no better choice than Google Sites. Here I am within a template, which which I've created, and I've named it Special Spring Events. So even if you have zero experience with creating a website, Google Sites makes it super easy for you to do. Everything is drag and drop, or just click in a space. If I want to come up here and rename this event, this is my special event right here, I can do so. And on the right-hand side, the ability to add different types of content or change the layout or navigate across my website makes it very easy as well. I think perhaps one of the best uses of Google Sites is if you are needing to create a landing page or a very simple website. Maybe you're hosting a webinar. Maybe you have an extra special deal or an extra special sale, and you don't want to include it in your entire website. You just want to send people to a special registration page, for example. Google Sites is absolutely excellent for those purposes. And if you're already a Google user, you have the advantage of accessing your Google Drive account or all of your photos directly from within the editor. So for example, maybe in this day three slot, I'm going to click on this plus button and I'm going to say select an image, and it's immediately going to bring me to my Google Drive. I'm going to select this image here and bam, it's directly in my website. Couldn't be easier for me to navigate and find the images and find that content that I want to include. Now, the next website on our list is going to make sharing your content and sharing other links so much more easier and also more inviting for your viewers. And we're talking about Bitly. Bitly is the easy way to take a long and complicated and maybe messy looking link and create something so much shorter, but also something that is a little more relevant so that your users will click and access that content. For example, here is a lengthy and somewhat messy looking URL, but with Bitly, I was able to condense it to just this, and it actually has some actionable words in it. Get Jotform app, for example. So let's show you how easy it is to create your own. In the top right hand corner, all I have to do is select the create button, and here I can paste in any link I want. I don't have to be the owner of that link, it could be absolutely anything on the web. So in this case, I'm pasting in a blog post from my own website, something that is going to be much too long to include in a social media post. I'm going to hit enter, and what Bitly is going to do is create a shortened link. Here it is. It's bit.ly/, and then we've got about 7 characters here behind it. But the nice thing is that I can go one step further and customize the back half. So in this case, maybe I'm going to call this Chrome add-ons. Let's see if I can use that. Now, Bitly is going to warn me if this Bitly link has been taken. So for example, this particular custom link has been taken by someone else. So I'm going to say try Chrome add-ons. Let's try that for a second and see if that one has taken. No, I can use that one. So now it tells me that the link has been edited. All I need to do is hit this copy button, and now I can paste this anywhere that I want, and people will be able to go directly to the desired page. On top of that, Bitly keeps track of your statistics. So if you want to see who has been clicking and where, you can keep track of your history here as well. Now, the next website in our list is not only going to make you look great online, but it's going to make your presentations really stand out so that they can be more engaging with your audience. Here I am at the Mentimeter website, and Mentimeter is all about creating content so that people can answer your polls, can answer your questions in real time. So for example, here I've set up a new type of presentation. I can choose from a variety of different options, whether that's a multiple choice, whether that's a scale, maybe a word cloud, or any of the options that are listed down below. Let's stay with multiple choice. So we need to start by asking a question. Which is your favorite social media platform, for example? Let's do that as our question. And then we obviously have to fill in our options. I'm going to put in Facebook. I'm going to put in Twitter. And then I'm also going to put in, well, yeah, it wouldn't be my video if I didn't say YouTube. So I'm going to say Facebook, Twitter, or YouTube. Now, there's a variety of other options we can make here, including editing images and, of course, changing the colors here on the screen as well. Now, when you're finished editing your question, or if you just want to see how it's going to look like for the people that you send it to, all you need to come up here is select the preview presentation. And whether they access this on their desktop or on their mobile device, this is how it's going to look like to them. So for example, if I select Facebook and select submit, I'm going to see that in real time. And others who go to this particular room, menti.com, and then enter in this code will be able to not only participate, but see the results as well. So a very quick and easy way to make your presentations that much more engaging. Of course, if you don't want your participants to remember this address and to type in this particular code, you can also hit the share button and copy the direct link. This is perhaps the easiest way for people to get into your polling slides. Or you can choose to download the QR code so that they go directly to your poll just by scanning with their phone. So a variety of different ways for you to take advantage of Mentimeter. Now, the next website on our list is something that I use on a very regular basis, and it's called Capitalize My Title. How often have you been putting together some content, whether that's a blog, podcast, video, or maybe something else for your website, and you're not sure exactly how you should capitalize that phrase or that title depending on all of the various styles? Well, Capitalize My Title makes it easy for you. Now, you can either paste in your title idea right here, or just start typing into the field. So I'm going to say how to create amazing designs for your website. And as you can see, it's going to dynamically change some of the capitalization based on what I've entered here. Now, at this point, I can select this copy and go and copy it and paste it wherever I like. But the other thing that I like is that Capitalize My Title has its own headline score. Here you can see down in small print, I've got a headline score of 70. So in this case, I can see I've received a readability score of 75 and an SEO score of 51. If I scroll down, you can read all of the details in terms of where you should be aiming and also maybe where I should be improving in this case. When it comes to maximizing your titles and getting the most eyeballs on your content, it's always great to have a tool such as this on your side. Next up, let's talk quick and easy photo editing. Have you ever wanted to make some touch-ups to your images, but you don't want to either pay for or download an expensive photo editing suite? Well, that's precisely where edit.photo comes into place, where you have all of the features that you would expect from a photo editor, but right from within your browser. So in this case, I'm going to say select a photo. I'm going to go and grab maybe this one right here. And let's say, I want to crop it maybe a little bit. So I'm going to come down here and crop it to the way that I like it to be. Maybe I want to put a filter on this image. I can do so as well. Whether you're looking to make some small adjustments or you want to add some annotation or resize your image, you can do it all right here with edit.photo. So rather than downloading those images and doing it on your desktop, you can do it right here within your browser with edit.photo. Now, of course, I'd love to hear from you next. What are some of the websites that help you look amazing and save time online? Be sure to let me know in the comments down below. And if you enjoyed this video, you might also enjoy these videos as well. Remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.